We know that chloroplast is a unique organelle in plant cells because it has its own DNA and they reproduce the same way as bacteria. Why is it so? There is a widely accepted explanation to this, which is called the endosymbiotic theory proposed by Lynn Margulis. Once upon a time, there was these ancient prokaryotic cells. The smaller one is called cyanobacteria. It is able to self-generate energy using light, while the larger one is unable to make its own food, so it ingests other cells to get energy. And one day, the larger cell engulfed the smaller cell. So the larger one became the host cell and the smaller one remains a cyanobacteria. Both of them retain their own DNA. As they live along together, the host cell provides protection and nutrients to the cyanobacteria, and the cyanobacteria provides energy for the host cell. This is what we call the symbiosis relationship. And slowly as they evolve, the cyanobacteria lost some of its DNA that it cannot live independent of the host cell. Eventually, the cyanobacteria became an organelle of the host called chloroplast, which is specialized in carrying out photosynthesis to generate energy. Because this symbiotic relationship occurred within a cell, it's called endosymbiotic theory. And now, when we cut open a chloroplast, we can see a few structures. First, thylakoid is a sheet-like membrane-bound structure that contains chlorophyll which absorbs light for photosynthesis. The disc-like shape of thylakoid maximizes the surface area to carry out photosynthesis. When thylakoids are stacked up, we call the structure granum. Carbohydrates produced by thylakoids can be stored as starch granule. While lamella is the skeleton of chloroplast, it makes sure that the thylakoids have a safe distance from each other and maximize efficiency of the organelle. Since chloroplast is a double membranous organelle, it has outer membrane and inner membrane. The outer membrane is semi-porous, which allows small ions and molecules to pass through, while the inner membrane regulates the activity of materials in and out of chloroplast. The outer membrane and inner membrane is separated by intermembranous space. The lumen and stroma are aqueous medium for biochemical reactions to take place in chloroplast. And apart from this, chloroplast has its own ribosomes and DNA. The DNA is circular and free, unlike the nuclear DNA, which is enclosed with membranes. The way that chloroplast DNA evolved is very different from nuclear DNA. Since it is only inherited from the mother side and evolved relatively slow compared to nuclear DNA and mitochondrial DNA, it acts as a good source of original markers, which is useful for molecular studies. Here, we discuss some commonly used genetic markers and some gene regions that are not as popular. First, a commonly used gene is RBCL. It is a protein-coding gene which codes for Rubiscol large subunit. Rubiscol is the most abundant and important enzyme in plants that catalyzes two reactions, carbon dioxide fixation and photorespiration. And why is it a popular genetic marker? Is that it has ideal length, high abundance, which ensures high success in gene extraction and amplification, universal to all plants so we can use the published primers for PCR, and it is easy to align. RBCL also have high substitution rate, so it provides informative sites to distinguish among organisms at low taxonomic level. Another commonly used gene is maturase K gene. It is a protein coding gene that encodes a maturase involved in group 2 intron splicing. And intron splicing is the removal of introns and joining of exons during transcription in order to produce mRNA. Why is maturase K gene popular? It has ideal length, high rate of substitution, high interspecific divergence, easy to amplify using published primer sequences, and is versatile for identification at family, genus, and even species levels. Next, we move on to RPOB gene, which is not as commonly used as RBCL and maturase K. The function of RPO gene is to encode the beta subunit of the plastid-encoded RNA polymerase, also called as PEP. And what is PEP? It is an enzyme that mediates the transcription of photosynthesis-related genes. RPOB gene is not a popular genetic marker because it's relatively more conserved and is not so informative to distinguish among family and species. However, it is more widely used in studies of bacteria than plants. Another unpopular gene is ATPB to RBCL spacer. It is a non-coding gene region which acts as promoters for RBCL and site of RNA cleavage. The reason that it is not popular is it has different sizes in different organisms, so it's difficult to be used. And it also has low substitution rate and lack of informative variation site to differentiate species.